Greetings, everyone. Migration is becoming a hot topic in the United States of America as Americans prepare to go for presidential elections in November 2024, just as we saw in South Africa in May, when the question of migration was an election issue. And we know that in as South Africa goes to local government elections in 2026, migration is going to be a hot topic. It's going to be top on the agenda because there are other parties that believe that they lost votes on the migration because of the migration question. Some, they say they won because of migration question. But of course, we have a different view, which we'll discuss some other time. So a few days ago, the United States Vice President Kamala Harris went to the border with the U.S. and Mexico. According to this publication, written on the 28th of September 2024, it says she went there, quote, to blunt Republican attacks on immigration, close quote. Harris, that is the Deputy President of the United States, is accusing Donald Trump of what she calls scapegoating instead of solutions and rhetoric instead of results. You remember that Donald Trump won the presidency on his rhetoric on the question of migration. Opinion polls in the United States suggest that more Americans trust Donald Trump over Harris on handling the border and the illegal immigration. According to this article that I'm quoting from, it says, I quote, every year, thousands of undocumented migrants walk through Mr. Chilton's 50,000-acre ranch just south of Arivaca. He has motion-activated cameras that show the procession of people all dressed in near-identical camouflage across his land. He is convinced the drug dealers and gang members are among them. Close quote. So there's a lot of movement. You remember that that is a lot of movement between the U.S. and Mexico. You remember that Donald Trump proposed to build a wall between the United States and Mexico. Comrade Nkosi Conan Dibiti from Bulilima in Zimbabwe, he is in the United States. He had an opportunity to go on a study tour to the border of Mexico and the United States, and he gave me permission to use his notes he posted. Let me quote what Comrade Ndibiti says, because he draws parallels between what he saw on the border between the United States and Mexico and on the border between Zimbabwe and South Africa. So he writes, I quote, a fortnight ago, I joined the Hubert H. Humphrey Fellowship Program at Arizona State University Fellows on a visit to the U.S.-Mexico border in Nogales. He says they met with the various stakeholders, that is U.S. Border Control, Mexico Consul, the mayor, NGOs, and journalists who cover migration stories to grasp the complexities of migration. He then says, which is of interest to us, he says, I quote, this experience drew parallels with the migration issues at the Zimbabwe-South Africa border in Beitbridge, particularly the similarities in migrants' border crossing methods and resorting to asylum seeking. Non-governmental organizations provide shelter and health care, highlighted the immense daily influx could reach up to 1,500 people per day into the U.S., close quote. I remember we went to Musina as part of our work, where we found that a local church in Musina was providing shelter for people that would have crossed to South Africa. Because most people, when they cross the border, they become stranded. Some they will not be having relatives or not knowing where to go, or some they will have been robbed of their money. They are already on the South African side. They don't have money to proceed to go wherever they want to go. So some churches in Musina, like the church that we visited before COVID, providing a shelter, which Comrade Ndivitu speaks about in the context of the US-Mexico border, to say some NGOs are also providing shelter. And then he continues, I quote, "My key takeaway is the importance of amplifying migration stories. Local journalists in Nogales offered fresh insights into US-Mexico migration, highlighting the vital role local media organizations play in sharing lived realities. These journalists regularly interview immigrants, give them a voice shedding light on their experiences navigating legal and illegal border crossings. I firmly believe media should serve all voices, not just the elite or experts. Marginalized communities must be given a platform. By sharing their stories, we can foster empathy and understanding, ultimately driving positive change in migration policies. In Zimbabwe, hyperlocal media organizations like Community Podium and others could explore ways of documenting these migration stories and their impact to the border, to the broader society," a close quote. So it is, and we agree with the comrade in Nkosikhona Ndivitu, that media must play a critical role in highlighting the challenges that migrants face. You have women that cross the border carrying babies on their back. You have women that are being raped by what we call amagumbagumba at the border, those that assist people to cross through illegal entry points. So there is a lot of ill treatment or human rights abuse that occurs when people are crossing the border, because also part of the problem is the passport fee in Zimbabwe, because people do not afford to apply for $170 passport to about 5,000 rands. So this is why we always call on the government to reduce the price of passport so that people are able to cross without using illegal crossings. And also in the last video, we spoke about the children that were coming to visit their parents in South Africa from Matabele North in Zimbabwe, we crossed through Botswana to South Africa. Then they were intercepted and they spent the entire holiday in police detention. So these are the challenges that undocumented people face when they then cross the border. And of course, on this one, on children, we said that it's important that parents apply for their children's passport. Please share your views as we draw parallels in the election campaign in South Africa, I mean in the United States of America, on the question of migration with South Africa and also with Europe. You know that what was formerly East German, the right-wing political formations, are now in control because of their anti-migrant attitude. So let's keep on discussing these issues. Please write in the comment section, like this video, subscribe to this YouTube channel. If you are on TikTok, please do follow us. Otherwise, Amandla, comrades.